we want to describe the type of transformation that would occur to the basic function f of x. Our first two functions are y equals 4 times f of x and y equals 1/4 times f of x. Notice in these two, we're multiplying the function values by a constant, and the function values are the y values. So if we're multiplying the y values by a constant, it will either vertically stretch or vertically compress the function. In the second two examples, we have y equals f of 5x and y equals f of 1/5 x. Notice in this case, we're multiplying x by a constant to find the input of the function. And since the inputs lie along the horizontal axis, these two will either horizontally compress or horizontally stretch the parent function f of x. Let's look at this further. Let's first consider how a would affect the graph of f of x. If a is greater than 1, for example, if we had the graph of our parent function y equals f of x here, and then graphed y equals 2 times f of x, because we're multiplying the function values of the parent function by 2 for 2 times f of x, it would vertically stretch the function by a factor of 2. If we took points on the parent function and wanted to find points on 2 times f of x, we would multiply each y coordinate by a, or in this case, positive 2. And then if a is between 0 and 1, for example, if a is 1/2 or 0.5, notice how the graph of y equals 0.5 times f of x is what's called a vertical compression, because now the y coordinates of the parent function are multiplied by 1/2 to find points on 0.5 times f of x. So we'd say this is vertically compressed by a factor of 1/2. So going back to our examples, y equals 4 times f of x would vertically stretch f of x by a factor of 4. And y equals 1/4 times f of x would vertically compress f of x by a factor of 1/4. Now let's take a look at some notes on horizontal compressions and stretches, meaning we want to determine how b would affect the graph of f of x. So starting with the parent function again, y equals f of x here, if we considered where b is equal to 2, we would have the graph of y equals f of 2x graphed here, and notice how the graph has been horizontally compressed. The reason it's horizontally compressed is because if we consider this point on the parent function, notice how this would be where f of 4 is equal to 0, but for f of 2x, it only takes an x value of 2 to have the same input of 4. Since we have 2 times x, if x is 2, we'd have an input of 4. So on the horizontally compressed function, when x is 2 here, we have an output of 0. So if we started with points on the parent function, we'd have to multiply each x coordinate of the parent function by 1 over b, or in this case 1/2, to find the coordinates of the points on the horizontally compressed function. And because we multiply each x coordinate by 1/2, we're going to say that the graph is horizontally compressed by a factor of 1 over b, or in this case 1/2. And then if b is between 0 and 1, for example, we'll consider when b is 1/2, in red we see the graph of y equals f of 1/2 x, or f of 0.5 x, and notice how the graph has been horizontally stretched. The reason it's horizontally stretched is because notice how to get the same function values as the parent function, the x values would have to be multiplied by 2 to get the same output. Again, we know f of 4 equals 0 on the parent function, but x would have to be equal to 8 on f of 0.5 x to get the same output, since 0.5 times 8 would give us an input of 4. So once again, if we had points on the parent function, we'd have to multiply each x coordinate by 1 over b, or in this case, 1 over 1/2, or the reciprocal of 1/2, which would be 2, to find the x coordinates on the horizontally stretched function that would give us the same function values. So going back to our last two examples, for y equals f of 5x, this would horizontally compress f of x by a factor of 1 over 5, or 1/5, meaning the graph of f of 5x would be 1/5 as wide as the graph of f of x. And therefore, y equals f of 1/5 x would be horizontally stretched by a factor of the reciprocal of 1/5, or 5. So it's horizontally stretched by a factor of 5, meaning the graph of f of 1 fifth x would be 5 times as wide as the graph of the parent function f of x. I hope you found this explanation helpful.